Mary from Cycle Maintenance Academy here. Today we're going to have a look at bicycle spokes. Before we start, don't forget to like our video and subscribe to our channel. Okay, let's begin.
Spokes play a crucial role in a wheel. Because they do such a good job, spokes are often ignored, until that is, they start failing. This causes the wheel to lose strength and integrity, and eventually your bike can become unrideable. Spokes are the thin rods that radiate from the hub to the rim. One end is splayed out and that sits in the hole in the hub. The other end has a thread and this attaches to the nipple that passes through the hole in the rim. Because the spokes in a wheel are the same length, they keep the hub in the centre of the rim, and because they are very tight, they keep the rim round. Each spoke is roughly the same tension, tightness, in any given wheel. And that tension is adjusted and fine-tuned by tightening and loosening the nipple at the threaded end of the spoke. The end of the spoke that is attached to the splayed part is either hooked or straight. J-bend spokes. Many hubs are compatible with this spoke. The elbow is the weak point and is often where the spoke breaks. Straight pull spokes. They are lighter and less prone to breaking, but truing and building is more difficult because the spoke can spin. Spokes can be made of a number of different materials, but the most common is stainless steel. It offers strength, flexibility and lightness. There are three types of stainless steel spokes. They can be plain gauge, butted or bladed. Plain gauge. Budget spokes that have less flexibility than butted spokes. These spokes are the same thickness all the way along. Single butted. They are fatter at the hub end and then the same gauge for the rest of the spoke. This strengthens the spoke at the weakest point. Double butted. They are similar to the single butted spokes but have additional strengthening near the nipple. Further strength is added by the middle part being thinner and therefore more flexible. Triple butted. They have an extra thick gauge near the hub end to further strengthen the weakest point. They are stronger but heavier than double butted and are designed for long distance touring and some mountain biking. Bladed. They are flattened in the middle and are generally stronger than butted spokes because a further forging process is applied. Not only are they strong but also more aerodynamic. To create a wheel, spokes are fitted in different patterns. Cross pattern. This is the most common lacing pattern and uses the spokes to optimise their inherent strength and flexibility. No cross slash radial. This gives the lightest wheel because this build uses the shortest spokes. It is used on front wheels as the spoking pattern means there is less flexibility in the wheel. Even the strongest and best built wheel won't last forever, and spokes can break. But it's not all bad news. If one spoke breaks, and the problem is identified quite soon after the event, a new spoke can be fitted and the wheel tensioned again. As spokes come in various lengths, it is important to replace them with the ones matching the measurements. A J-bend spoke is measured from the middle of the bend to the end of the thread, and a straight pull from the splayed end to the end of the thread. Two wheels that are the same diameter will probably have different spoke lengths, as the wheel is built using a number of different factors.
Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. You can find many articles on our blog page. Follow the link below.